So today we're going to be testing some links with NVDA screen reader. There are a couple of tests that our links must pass in order to be accessible. First of all, they must be able to be selected by the screen reader. They must be descriptive, meaning that when a user focuses them, the screen reader should output a narration that would hint to the user on what page they're going to be redirected. And then the links must also hint to the user if they're going to be opened in a new window. So let's start to test some of the links. Our first link is Contact Us. Here I have my links, how they are outputted in the browser, and on the left I have them in their markup. So let's start with these links right here. I have fired up NVDA and now I'm going to be pressing the tab key to navigate through the links. Now let's select our first link, which is Contact Us.
Visited link Contact Us.
So the screen reader said visited link Contact Us. That's pretty good. So if I'm using the screen reader and I have my monitor turned off, I think I'm gonna go to the Contact Us page. This is a perfect example of a link. The screen reader noted that it's a link, so that means that its markup is correctly coded and it is descriptive enough. Now let's go to the next link.
Example.com visited link.
So the next link is less descriptive, so it only has the URL and it might be very obvious. Okay, so they're gonna bring us to example.com. However, just outputting the URL is not a good hint to the user, especially if the URL is not very well known. Like if it's facebook.com, for example, it should be easier. However, there should be many pages in facebook.com. So for example, if there was no text, but the screen only said facebook.com, for example, it is more likely that the user is going to get redirected to the website's Facebook profile. Not to mention that a lot of screen readers, they don't output the URL as cleanly as NVDA did. For example, some screen readers might read the URL letter by letter. So they might say https://example.com, which is really, really bad for user experience. So this link fails our test. And as you can see, this link is it's only a visual or a graphic or an icon link because it has no text, but it has an icon. Let's go to our next link, which is blog article.
Clickable blog article.
Okay, this one fails as well because even though the text is descriptive blog article, the screen reader says clickable. And the reason it says clickable and not a link is because this is not actually a link. It's made it look like a link, and if I click it, I will go to the URL. However, it is just a span that is being masked as a link. That is why it is so important to test with screen readers, because this right here looks like a link. Even when I hover over with my mouse, it feels like a link, but it's actually a span. And instead of saying blog article link, it says blog article clickable. In order to fix this, we must get rid of the span, we must get rid of the JavaScript, the onclick JavaScript, and we must replace it with an href. And you might be thinking, well, Stefany, what's the big deal if the screen reader can activate it? Well, the big deal is if the user doesn't know it's a link, it doesn't know how to activate. It might not know how to activate it, and it doesn't know the user. There is a possibility that the user would not know what the action is going to be taken after they click the element, because clickable, it might mean a button, might mean a slider, might mean an accordion. There are a lot of things that fall into the clickable umbrella. That's why it is very important that the markup is correct, okay? So this link, blog article, it fails our test. Now let's go to the next link, which should be watch our videos.
Watch our videos button.
This link fails our test as well because it says button and not link. So it is very similar to the span. If we navigate, let's navigate using the space bar. We are redirected as well, but we have absolutely the same problems. So we have to change the markup from button to link. Now let's go to the next one.
Monster Pigeons visited link.
Okay, so Monster Pigeon seems like a very good link, even though they will get redirected to some monster pigeons, which is something I don't want to look at unless I'm playing a horror game. But let's activate the link and see what happens. We have activated the link, but as you can see, we are redirected in a new website. However, a new tab is open. And we were not given an advance warning that a new tab was going to be open. So this link also fails our test. In order for the link to be descriptive, it must also set correct expectations to the user. So when I click a link, I don't usually expect it to open in a new window unless I'm given some sort of a hint. So this one fails this as well. Now let's go to the next link.
Click here visited link.
So click here might seem like a very good link. However, it says click here, which makes it non-descriptive. And so it fails the test. Never use click here or here because the user doesn't know where they're gonna go. And you might be thinking, well, Stefany, there's probably text above it that tells where the user is gonna go. Well, that's true. However, some users navigate the site only using tab or only using interactive elements such as links. That's why your links must be very descriptive. So this one fails as well. It's semantic. It has text. However, it's not descriptive. Let's go to the next link.
Learn more visited link.
So you might be thinking that this link is also going to fail. However, learn more is usually attached next to a card, and there's usually like a heading that says, for example, if it's part of a blog post excerpt, there's a heading that tells the user the title of the blog post, and that heading is usually a link. So if there is context, then this will pass the test. Because it's okay to use learn more if there is surrounding text or if there is an identical link which is going to be more descriptive. So for example, the heading that is also linked to the blog post will say the name of the blog post. However, if there is no other link, then just learn more by itself is not going to be descriptive. So I'm going to say that this doesn't fail or it doesn't pass. It needs more context in order for me to make a final judgment. And now let's go to the last link, which is Evil Flamingos.
File menu button view site information.
And as you can see, we have selected the file. And why have we selected the file? Because the screener has reached the end of all interactive elements, and the next one is just going to be this file. So you might be thinking, well, Stefany, why didn't the screener selected the Evil Flamingos? Because the tab index was disabled for Evil Flamingos link, which makes this link fail the test, since in order for screen readers to read out the links, they must be focusable. And by placing tab index minus one, we have disabled the automatic focusable thing that happens to links. So that's why this link also fails. So we have a lot of links that have failed, and the only link that has actually passed our test is going to be contact us. And this one we don't know yet because we need more context. Now let's see how we can fix those links real quick. This link, we can fix it very quickly. I'm going to press Insert plus S.
Speech mode off.
To disable the speech mode of my screen reader. And now get to coding and quickly fix those links so they're accessible. So the first one passes, so we don't need to do anything for that. This one is a graphic link. So what we need to do is we need to add an area label and we need to say home. So what this will do is when it's focused by the screen reader, instead of saying example.com, it's going to say home. So this is like an invisible text, if you like. Now the next link is this clickable span blog article. In order to fix it, all we have to do is just delete the span and replace it with a link. However, let's say that it is impossible to replace the span with a link. How do we make it accessible? Well, one way to do that is to add a row and set it to link. What this is going to do is going to hinder the screen reader saying, hey, I know this element is not supposed to be an anchor because it's not using the anchor element. However, let's pretend that it is. And user is not going to know the markup, so they're going to think it's a link. So this is like a temporary fix. Now, this is not fixed yet entirely because we also need to activate the link on spacebar, which is additional JavaScript we have to write. However, we're not going to look into that because it is still focusable and interactable by screen reader. So this is like a temporary fix until we can write our JavaScript for the span to be executed with the spacebar. And we can do the same thing with this button here. So in order to fix it, of course, just replace the button with the anchor element. However, if that's not possible, what we can do is just add the row link. And buttons are already activated using both spacebar and enter, so we don't have to write any additional JavaScript for that, which is good. So this one is also accessible now. And then we have the next one, which is monster pigeons. The problem with monster pigeons is that it opens in a new window. Now, the easiest fix is just to delete this and not open it in a new window or tab because it's inaccessible. There are many ways you can fix that, but we're going to do a quick and dirty one. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just write it over here. Opens in new window. This is the quick and dirty. You can also use aria described by and link it to an ID. But what we can do is, this is just quick and dirty, but it's going to make it way more accessible than it was before, because at least now the user is going to be hinted that it's opened in a new tab. So the next one is click here. And for this, we're going to need additional context. But let's say that it's part of an article that talks about dogs. So maybe it linked some dog toy. So I'm going to say, you know, chewing toy, okay? Which is, let's pretend this is the article that, let's pretend that they linked an Amazon page where they're saying chewing toys for dogs, okay? So now it's much easier for users to distinguish where they're going to go once they click on the link. So the other one is learn more. I'm going to pretend it's part of an excerpt for a blog post, so let's pretend that's working, and that's working for now. And the last link is going to be Evil Flamingos. The problem with this one is that it has type index minus one. Now what type index minus one does is it removes the type index. So if I start, if I start traversing through my links, I cannot select them with the tab key. So I'm pressing tab key and I am learn more. And when I press it again, I can't select Evil Flamingos. And that's because of type index minus one. It removes that focusable thing that happens. However, you can still enable it via JavaScript. So this is type index minus one is used, for example, if you want to make a non-focusable element focusable, for example, a heading that you don't normally want to focus. It's a whole other tutorial, but in order to fix it, all we have to do is just remove it. And since the links are focusable by default, they will get focused. And another way we can fix it is if we absolutely must have the attribute instead of minus one, we just write zero, and zero is going to make the element focusable. Okay, so we fixed our links, and let's test them again with our screen reader. Let me turn on my screen reader by pressing it. Actually, my screen reader is on. I have just disabled speech mode. So let me turn back speech mode with insert plus S.
Speech mode beeps. Speech mode talk.
Okay, and now let's test out links again.
Contact us visited link.
Okay, this one was good before. It's still good.
Home visited link.
See, this is much better than example.com.
Blog article link.
Okay, good.
Watch our videos link.
Good. Descriptive and semantic.
Monster pigeons opens in new window. Visited
good.
Link.
Good.
Chewing toy visited link. Learn more visited link. Evil flamingos visited link.
There we go. So that's how you test links. It's that easy.